Some of the hardest inputs to make in any business are those that don't show up with obvious advantages or benefits. Without concrete evidence, how can we be sure that the extra cost is worth it? While a fair question, I like to compare these inputs to insurance. Most of us take out insurance on our vehicles or for medical reasons because we understand the cost that can occur if something unexpected or negative were to happen. Today, I aim to compare the use of a good mineral program to that of proper insurance. Mineral supplementation can and will affect immune function, reproductive performance, and calf weight. Cattle require a combination of macro minerals, micro or trace minerals, and vitamins to optimize performance and production. Various setbacks can occur if any of these are missing from the diet. How can we be sure that our program is appropriate for the environment our cattle go to work in? Well, forage samples are a good place to start. Grass in the post-rock district varies greatly in composition from that of a different production system that may graze fescue, brome, or other native warm season grasses in different parts of the country. Phosphorus is one of the most prevalent examples. In heavy milking females that graze lush green grass, phos can become deficient and lead to problems with skeletal stability. It seems natural that we should provide as much phosphorus as we can through the mineral, right? Unfortunately, it's also one of the costliest components of a mineral supplement. By taking forage samples and visiting with your nutritionist or sales rep, you may be able to include phosphorus at a lower and cheaper rate while still providing adequate levels to your cowherd. Dr. Chris Reinhart reiterates that we have to be aware of the mineral balance of a forage a cow may be consuming, and we have to be aware of the demand that cow may have for those minerals. The same can be said for growing cattle or dry lotting cows in a controlled or semi-controlled environment. Feedstuff analysis should be kept on hand, especially if feeding a commodity that is highly variable, such as silage. The post-rock district will always be available to help sample or send feed and forage test in order to help producers greater understand the requirements of their cow herd. It's also highly important to note at what rate the mineral should be consumed. Mineral programs may range from 3 ounces to a half pound per head per day. For starters, this plays a financial role. While minerals designed for less consumption will more than likely be pricier on a per bag basis, of course, one bag or 50 pounds will provide more days worth of product. Furthermore, if mineral intake is below the suggested amount that it was formulated for, the cattle are not getting the total amount of vitamins and minerals that the program was designed to deliver. If they're going through the product too rapidly, your costs can jump in a hurry. For overconsumption, many producers will utilize salt blocks or mix in loose salt as means of controlling intake. What are some other considerations that are specific to spring and early summer? Say the herd is calving on time, but there are one or two females that didn't calve as expected. Sure, there are a number of factors that could influence this. However, if the females appear in good flesh and healthy, there's a chance that the group could be marginally deficient for copper, a trace mineral that's been linked to fertility in cattle. We've also talked about females in peak lactation being turned out to grass. Grass tetany can be a huge detriment to any operation when it strikes, and this stems from low levels of calcium and magnesium during this time period. Many companies will offer a high mag mineral designed for this season to prevent grass tetany and also to enhance breed back rates. It's important to think ahead with mineral programs. When increasing levels of a certain mineral or vitamin, they should be introduced to the diet about 6 weeks in advance of when they are truly needed. In the grand scheme of things, a mineral supplement is one of the most important aspects of any operation. While they won't replace poor nutrition or environment, the right program can sure fill the gaps in those areas. As we mentioned earlier, producers may not see concrete advantages to supplementing a quality product. But without one, herd health and production cycles can be highly compromised, leaving you in a tight spot financially. Even getting one more young female bred or helping an older cow wean a calf for an additional year can make a big impact, especially in times of high market volatility and tight profit margins. Visit with your preferred veterinarian, nutritionist, or myself with the Post-Rock Extension District at any time to ensure that your cow herd is in good shape from a mineral and vitamin standpoint. This has been Barrett Simon with Post-Rock Extension District No. 1.